When the fights are over, Darien, prove the man in many battles that a courage nothing rattles. Prove the man in many battles that a courage nothing rattles.
Lock your window very carefully, Nadina. They say an enemy spy is in the neighborhood.
Yes, Mother.
They say this spy is handsome and reckless and wouldn't hesitate for a moment to climb into anybody's window. I'd better rush right in and lock my window.
Yes, Mother.
Handsome, reckless. What am I rushing for?
Oh, the war will be over soon and Father will be coming home to you, Mother.
Yes. Well, after a year, I'll even be happy to see your father, the old Walrus.
My mother! Ah, just look at this picture of Alexius, my hero.
Isn't he handsome?
My mother, he's my fiancé. Besides, you're far too interested in uniforms.
Oh, it's not the uniforms, dear. It's everything they put inside.
Well, my Alexius wrote me that single-handed he won the Battle of Slavinsky. Oh, my hero. Oh, will I ever be worthy of him, his courage, his noble nature?
I have a true and noble lover. He is my sweetheart, all my own. His life on earth, who shall discover? His heart is
in a mirror. Where am I?
You are in a boudoir of an unmarried lady.
Oh, thank heaven. No husband.
What do you want?
Beautiful one, will you hide me?
Hide you? My enemy?
Oh, I'm no enemy. I'm Swiss. Lieutenant Boomerly.
Well, that makes no difference. Leave the way you came.
I'm much too tired. I'd only fall and break my neck.
I don't care what happened to your neck.
My neck cares. My head would be very unhappy if anything happened to my neck. Besides, I'm starving. There's not a chocolate drop left in my cartridge belt.
Chocolate drop? In your cartridge belt? Well, where do you carry your bullets?
Bullets? Oh, I never use bullets. You know, people can get killed from bullets. All you get from chocolate is a stomachache.
Well, I do happen to have a few caramels. Here you are.
Hmm.
Well, take the wrappers off first. Oh.
Sorry. Hmm, these are delicious.
Dear lady.
You're an angel. And when you come close to me like that, do you hear me bubbling? Hot chocolate.
And he calls himself a soldier.
Oh, you little chocolate soldier man, you're far too sweet and pretty. Oh, you funny chocolate soldier man, for you I feel great pity. Oh, you silly chocolate soldier man, just made to please your mistress. So sweet to
and not a soldier heaven made. I studied shooting, practiced riding. I studied fencing, fate deciding. I am a warrior by chance and not a hero of romance. I am her chocolate soldier man. She thinks me sweet and pretty. I am her chocolate soldier man, for me she feels great pity. I am not a chocolate soldier man, just made to please young missus, and I would not melt if I ever felt the sweetness of your kisses.
Oh,
you
funny chocolate soldier man, for you she feels
great
pity.
Oh, you silly chocolate soldier man,
just
made
to please your missus. So sweet to love if you
will. I'd like to try your kisses.
Do you like to try? Do you like to try? Do you like to try?
Don't you think you'd better go now, you chocolate soldier?
Do you want your chocolate soldier to be shot?
Well, you're not my chocolate soldier. I'm engaged to a real soldier. Alexius doesn't eat chocolate. He's a hero. He led the cavalry charge that won the Battle of Slavinsky.
Oh, you know why? His horse ran away with him.
I don't believe it.
Oh, I was there. He was the most accidental hero in history.
Not Alexius. My hero.
Mm-hmm. Oh, I didn't realize how tired I am. I've got to get a few winks of sleep.
Oh, no, get up. You can't sleep here.
Cozy.
Don't, please. Here, open your eyes, Lieutenant Bummerly. Here, please.
Hey, Zita.
Yes, Mother?
There are soldiers downstairs. They think the spy came in here.
Oh, Mother, I...
A man. What's he doing sleeping in your boudoir? Oh, wake up! Wake up!
Isn't he good looking?
Oh, please, Mr. Bummerly, wake up.
Go away. Go away. Don't bother me. I'm dreaming. Chocolate. Hey, dear.
He seems like such a tired, dear boy. I'll just hold his hand and stroke his head. And Agina, what are you doing?
Tearing up Alexia's picture.
What? Why, I thought he was your hero.
Oh, Mother, the strangest thing has happened. I don't think I like heroes anymore. I like chocolate and chocolate soldiers.
I slept there all night in Nadina's bedroom. with Nadina sighing and her mother stroking my hair and holding my hand. And along about morning, the two women gave me a house coat belonging to Nadina's father so that I could escape unnoticed. I waved them each a kiss and scampered down the waterfront.
He's gone.
Gone.
Gone. You're so right. Gone. Father will come home to you.
The old walrus. Oh, dear Pete. No more handsome soldiers climbing in our window.
Father and Alexius, oh, now that you're both back home, you must tell us more about your adventures.
Well, at the Battle of Slavinsky...
Oh, Alexius, we've heard all about that.
They don't want to hear about war, my boy. They want to hear about romance. Let's tell them about Boomerly.
Boomerly?
Yes, odd name. Well, this fellow Boomerly told us about a wonderful romance he had with two women whose names he refused to reveal.
Let's get back to the Battle of Slavinsky.
It seems he climbed up into the room of a very pretty miss who fell head over heels in love with him, hid him, protected him, and kissed him.
Why, it's a lie. I don't believe it.
Wait till you hear about the other one. He said the girl's mother held his hand and stroked his hair. He called her a real flirtatious old crow.
Oh, the impertinent puppy.
And when he left in the morning, she gave him her husband's house coat to wear and said, the old walrus will never know. Wasn't that funny?
Not very funny for the old walrus.
Talking about house coats, I think I'll go put mine on.
House coat?
Come with me, Alexius. We'll talk about your wedding plan. Just think, Nadina, before you know it, Alexius will be your husband.
Bummerly, whose life I saved.
Bummerly, a boomerang.
At your service, ladies.
Why, Bummerly, how did you get in here?
My favorite way, the window.
Well, get out of here, you ungrateful wretch.
She loves me.
You monster.
The mother loves me.
Who's got my house code?
The father's going to hate me.
Alexis and I have been looking everywhere for my...
Bummerly!
How do you do, Colonel Hopper?
What are you doing here?
Just renewing old acquaintances.
The two women you told us about.
My wife.
And my fiancé.
And your house coat.
Bummerly, you've been making hanky-panky.
Gentlemen, what can I say?
Forgive, forgive, forgive. Why was I there? I wished to live. For me were soldiers running, running. Their kind attentions I was shunning. I climbed up here to save my skin. That's why I refuge sought. Oh, what a sorry, sorry plight. Your daughter saved my life at night. She also wished to see me live. Forgive, forgive, forgive.
Forgive, forgive, forgive. Why is he there? He wished to live. And the soldiers running, running, the kind of tension he was charming.
I climbed up here to save my skin. That's why I refuge sought within. Oh, what a sorry, sorry plight. Daughter saved my life that night. She also wished to see me live.
I thought I was Nadina's hero. Now I'm merely a zero.
If he doesn't want her, I do. Colonel Popoff, I ask your daughter's hand in marriage.
Never.
Just a moment. What are your qualifications, young man? Nadina is used to great luxury. Look at our silver. Look at our linen.
Silver? Linen? Do you have 8,000 napkins, 7,000 sheets, 9,000 blankets, 10,000 knives and forks, a house with 200 rooms and 60 bathrooms?
Well, I do.
Who are you, the king of Switzerland?
I am the son and heir of the largest hotel proprietor in Switzerland.
Well, I don't care who you are. Get out.
But what's my answer?
I'll write you a letter.
Come, we will discuss it in the next room.
Now, pen and paper. Now a letter that will really tell Bummerly what I think.
My dear first Mr. Bummerly, most hateful you are now to me. The reasons why I plainly state. The first one is you came too late. And secondly, you're much too smart to please a simple maiden heart. And thirdly, you're an awful flirt. The man who ran the first of first.
That ought to show him.
Don't let me see you anymore. No, not anymore. With poor Nadina Popoff. There, Nadina Popoff. There.
Hello there.
How did you get in here?
Back through my window, my favorite entrance. I came to collect my letter. Isn't it thoughtful of me to save you the postage?
There. There's your letter.
I'm going to read it right here.
My dear sir, Mr. Bomberly, most hateful you are now to me. The reason why I plainly state, the first one is you came too late. Secondly, you're much too smart to please a simple maiden heart.
And thirdly, you're an awful flirt. Your manner is to flip and flirt.
Don't let me see you anymore.
Oh, not anymore.
With love, Nadina Popoff.
No.
Dear lady, I thank you.
For what?
The delicate manner in which this letter confesses your love for me. Now permit me to prove mine.
With a letter?
No, but it has something to do with the post office.
Oh?
Now I come close to you, and then I put my arms around you like this. Then I...
Oh, you taste just like chocolate.
Nadina, my love.
Yes?
Would you care for another chocolate?
My hero.
Fun playing Nadina tonight. You know, it's not often I get a chance to play a part that's so close to my own name.
Speaking for all soldiers, chocolate and otherwise, and all civilians, you were a lovely Nadine. Come pay us another visit soon, will you, when you're not too busy at the Met?
Oh, I'd love to, Gordon.
And by the way, try to listen next week, Nadine. We're doing Music in the Air with that lovely Jerome Kern score. And our guest is the charming young singing star, Janie Powell.
Oh, I'll be listening. And, oh, Gordon. Gordon.
Yeah.
Thanks for the chocolate.
You're pretty sweet yourself.